Prayer and devotion on this Saturday. Today is Saturday. It is the first day of July, and it is good to be with all of you as we start this day. That was Lauren Daigle off of her North Point Music Beginnings album, singing It Is Well, and it is a good and joyful thing to be able to gather with you this morning. So good morning to all of you. And today we're going to be looking at Proverbs 12, verse 25. So Proverbs 12, 25, our theme for today is the rested soul. The rested soul. And it is still smoky out there, so that's why I've got this constant thing in my throat. But anyway, it's good to be with you this morning. Let me say good morning to Donna. It's good to have you here this morning, Donna, praying for you as we start the day. And Barbara, I'm glad you're here with us too, holding you in prayer this morning. Good morning, Michelle. Welcome home, I think you're back. I hope you had a wonderful vacation. It's good to have you here praying for you this morning. And good morning, Susan. I'm glad you're with us praying for you this day. And Renata, welcome, holding you in prayer as well. Good morning, Blanca. I'm glad you're with us praying for you. And Andrea, it's good to have you here holding you in prayer this morning as well. Good morning, Marilyn. I'm glad you're with us, holding you in prayer today. And Genevieve, it's good to have you here, holding you in prayer as well. And good morning, Lynetta. I'm glad you're with us too, praying for you today, praying for all of you as we begin the day together. So today's devotion comes from Proverbs 12:25. So as you open your Bibles up to Proverbs, my name is Cindy Stauffer. I'm blessed to serve as the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. And we would always love to have you join us for church, whether in person or virtually. Our worship is on Sunday morning. That's tomorrow at 11. And so I hope you can join us for that time of worship. But I'm glad you're with us right now. So we're going to take a look at Proverbs 12, verse 25. I'm just going to do the one verse, so I'm going to read it for us twice. Proverbs 12, 25 says this: anxiety weighs down the human heart, but a good word cheers it up. Anxiety weighs down the human heart, but a good word cheers it up. Today's devotion is entitled The Rested Soul, and it comes from Joyce Meyer's Strength for Each Day. She says, when we think of Jesus, we see a picture of perfect rest and peace. Although he often encountered situations that could have upset him, he always remained at peace. This was because he trusted his Heavenly Father with everything in his life. It seems today that most of us hurry, scurry, and worry about a multitude of things. But interestingly enough, all the hustle and anxiety are a waste of time, and they never accomplish anything good. I invite you today to cast your care on God and let God take care of you. 1 Peter 5:7. Stop incessantly thinking and talking about your problems and go about the business of living and enjoying your life while God takes care of your problems. If worry were effective, I would urge you to do it. But every result of worry and anxiety is negative. It can cause health problems, relationship problems, and emotional problems. So instead of worrying, God's word invites us to be anxious for nothing, and in all things to pray and be thankful. Philippians 4:6. The result of this is peace. Instead of thinking about your problems, start thinking about your blessings, and you will soon see that your life is not so bad after all. God has helped you in the past, and God will do it again. Yes. Sometimes I feel like we keep coming back to the same message, and you know, there's always a reason why, because we need to hear it over and over and over again. So as I was listening to today's song from Lauren Daigle. She does a version of It Is Well With My Soul, which was written by Horatio Spafford after he had lost like basically everything in his life. You know, his children, he had been a part of building up Chicago, and then there was the big fire. He lost a son. He lost two daughters in a ship that went down in the Atlantic, and he was traveling to go and pick up his wife when he wrote It Is Well With My Soul. And it starts off with, when peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, when peace like a river attendeth my way. Now, one would say that peace would be the very last thing on his heart and mind, the very last thing. But I have found, and I'm sure that this is the same case for Horatio Spafford, that there are these moments when it feels as if everything has fallen out, right? All the things that we had depended on, all of the parts of our lives that we thought we had somehow had control over, all the things that we had worried and had anxiety about, fall out. And I don't know where it comes from. Well, I know where it comes from. But a peace will come upon us. And I'm quite sure that that's what happened to Horatio Spafford that day. He felt as if everything had been lost. But then the peace of Christ, the peace of God, came like a river and showed him the way, attendeth my way. It is not always easy to say it is well, because there are times when it doesn't feel like it is well. There are times when we would, when our first choice is to worry and have anxiety about what is happening or what might happen. But nothing good comes of it. That's the thing. And today, Joyce Meyer highlights that. Our anxiety does no benefit. It has no benefit. If it spurs us to move, okay, maybe that's the one benefit. But if we're just stuck in anxiety and it's not producing anything of value, anything that is life-giving, we are just wasting time. Time that could be used in so many other good and positive and life-giving ways. And so I come back again to this song from Lauren Daigle, because she adds a second part. She sings, it is well, through the storm I am held. And that's where that peace comes from. That no matter what you and I may be walking through, and Jesus had every reason to be anxious. Jesus had every reason to be anxious for the journey that was ahead. But Jesus knew that he was held. He knew the one who was holding him. And friends, it can be the same for you and I. No matter what you're walking through today, God will hold you through this storm. You don't have to be anxious for anything. Stop wasting your life away with worry. It brings nothing good, nothing. It harms our health. It harms our emotional health. It harms the people that are around us, even the ones, the people that we would never want to harm. But that's what it does. So today, I invite you to trust that through the storm, you are held. Through the storm, you are held. Can you believe that this day? As we come into this time of prayer, I'm just going to ask and invite you to rest. That was the title of today's devotion. A rested soul, can you rest in the arms of the one who loves you, who loved you first, who knew you and loved you before you took your first breath? Can you rest in the arms of God? As we come into this time of prayer, I invite you to the mantra or to the just the understanding that you are held. I am held. Let's pray. God, we come today with so much on our hearts and minds. So many fears and concerns and anxiety and worry. We come with the storms that seem to be raging around us. We come with so many unknowns. And yet we long for the rest that you offer us. Help us, Lord, to know this day that in all situations, in all places, in all times, in this moment, we are held. Forgive us for the times when we have tried to figure it all out on our own, when we have run around repeating the same fears and worries over and over again. Forgive us, Lord, for not trusting you more. Lead us back so that we might rest, that we might find rest for our weary souls. Help us to trust that we are held. No matter what the storms are, Lord, you are holding us this day. Lord, I pray for each person on the call right now, for each person that will listen later, that they will come to know that they too are held. The peace, like a river, can lead their way as well. Thank you, Lord, for holding us. Thank you, Lord, for giving us this moment to rest and to know that you are there. We ask all of this in your name, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. I am held. Let that be words that come back to your heart again this day. You are held. God loves you, my friends. And so do I. Have a very blessed day. And tomorrow I look forward to seeing you in worship. We're going to be honoring and celebrating our teachers that have taught over the last year, all the many people that were part of our children's ministry. So I hope you can come and be a part of that service. Of course, we'll also have Holy Communion, and we're starting a new sermon series on women in the Bible. So we're going to start with Deborah the prophet. And so I hope you can join us tomorrow for worship. And I look forward to seeing you then. Bye, friends.